Hi everyone, this is Rick from RJB Art Studio. I'm going to be drawing a little girl and like an Easter hat or whatever, another hat, and a nice little dress, some flowers behind her on the beach. Right, it's going to be something different. I'm going to sketch her out and probably going to paint over it, but it's going to be an acrylic, so starting right here. So our hat starts here. And it'll be like a flower right here. Pretty flower. Sunflower. On a hat and a ribbon. Holding it in. And she's facing towards the water. And the water, I think the sky will be about right here, I'd say. Something like that. Alright, so now we have her pretty hair. She has little curls. Little curly curl hairs. Okay, not getting too many details. I just want to show you. Hopefully you can see this. Look pretty. There's a rimmer on this, so. On the side here. She's going to kind of go off the canvas. I gotta erase that. Yeah. So she'll have this dress will be like a sundress. And there's sunlight coming on over here. It's really raining outside. Woo. And she's holding these flowers. This is a little smaller. Okay, now a little bowl that goes this way, a little loop. Shadow area here, light blasting over there, so cast a shadow on this side. This is all in shadow, kind of. and I'll define this better, you'll see it. And her dress goes kind of straight down like this. Flowers right here. All types of flowers, whatever. That's it. So that's a little girl, and she's going to be overlooking the ocean, you know, and a wave crashing here, a couple of waves out there, some clouds out there, and sand. That's it. All right, I'm going to just, okay. So I'm gonna get the paints ready and I'll be back. I'm putting on this golden satin glazing, all right, liquid, and it's by Golden. It just it keeps the paint wet and makes it blend. It helps it blend much better than normal since it's acrylic. Acrylics tend to dry so fast before we have a chance to do anything with it, you know. So I'm just taking care not to get any in the little girl there for now. That's all, just for now. So we have the sky and the water down here, and it's going to start turning into wet sand and then sand. That's good. Now I'm just going to have a, you know, a simple blue sky. So I have some white and cerulean blue. I'll start up top. It's actually going to mix on the canvas anyway, so I'm going to make some clouds in here after. So I'm going to kind of smooth it out a little bit. And this is a 11 by 14 canvas. Actually, I'm going to touch a little bit of ultramarine. Yeah, let me get a little ultramarine. Yeah. A deeper sky on the top anyway. Just gonna put it all in. Okay, now get some white. I'm just gonna get it all, some clouds here and there, everywhere. Touch it in there. Right. I'm just going to blend this in a minute and you'll see the effects it makes. Smooth clouds. Nothing standout-ish, if that's a word. I put a hint of alizarin, and I mean an itty bitty little hint for the. And you can't even see it. Yeah, something like that. Get a softer brush here. I have a soft, what is this, number 8 oval. Just gonna smooth it out a little bit, just some here and there. This whole thing will disappear if I go too hard. Just very softly. Just want action in the sky. Just a little more, little clouds here and there. Clouds everywhere, actually, on this one cloudy day. turning the brush, I'm just, you know, twirling it in circles just to give it a feeling of clouds. And I can fix it where I don't like it. And some more color here and there. Take it from the top, come down. Okay, I'm a plain sky there. You can just play with this until you know, you feel you like it the way it is, and cancel it. I mean, don't continue once you've got what you're looking for. It's kind of an abstract anyways, but all right, I may go back in there after it dries and, you know, maybe throw some more clouds or whatever. All right, here we go. Not gonna spend too much time on that. Now I'm gonna add a little green, touch of green here. I just have some Hooker's green and some blue. Yeah, let me change brushes first. Clean this brush. I'm gonna go back to my 3/4 inch brush. Clean that one off. So ultramarine, and I'm using this palette. It keeps the palette wet, so I don't have to waste paint. And that's the Masterson. That's the cover. Anyway, just to show you. So I'm mixing the blue, some white, and green. It's a deep ocean color. Maybe a little more blue. I'm just gonna kind of go like this for now. Yeah, too much green there. More blue. I want it fairly dark. Just gonna push it in. Very fast. I just want to get this color in first. Yeah, as you can see, it's a little harder to do it this way. I mean, compared to, you know, just doing it later, but I didn't want to. I wanted this to be a little easier. Well, it's easier for you guys to watch. Again, all right, just kind of bounce the brush in like this. Color. Define these little waves. Okay, now I'm gonna put some brown color for the beach. Sand, yellow ochre, and brown mixed. I'm just gonna mix that. This will be the base. Oh yeah, what I can do is put a little of this on it first. I mean, also mix this up too. This makes it slide better and mix. Let's just scrub this in for now. I need the color in there, so. And I get some yellow, I mean some dark sienna. Okay. Okay, kind of on an angle a little bit. Whatever, it doesn't, I don't want it even. All right, and this is going to be the water coming. Some of it's shining through. I'm going to add some white to this color. Alright, that was good. You gotta make it a little rougher, I think, right here. Make it look real, you know? Yeah, break it up a little bit like this. And get some more brown color. A little ochre, some white. Just break that up. All right. Just stand that a little more. Okay. I'm liking that better already. Yeah. Just a lot of white on the brush here. I'm just gonna get some of these clouds defined for the foreground. I just want some messy clouds up here. Actually, it's gonna come way up. Let's swirl that in. Yeah, right there is good. Take that off. Let's get it in there somewhere. That's all. Alright. Looks good. Okay, so I'm putting more blue, I decided. Just up top here. Alright, I'm just gonna get this in there. Yeah, I'll define the. It's like a negative painting type of deal, you know? Because you can't really see these clouds anyway. So I'm gonna make them defined by putting blue here and there. It's a little trick I learned from different artists, actually. Right. Just looks a little better with the hint of blue against the clouds, you know? I can even put this in here if I want. Yeah, well, it's wet, you know? Yeah, that's just better. Much better. Much better. I like it a lot better. Alright, and then right above her head, I want a little bit of clouds there too. I mean, sky, I should say. It's got motion there. Let's give it some shadow looks. Okay, that's better. Cool. Okay, so I'm going to use the number 12 flat brush. Alright. And I am going to get a light shade of blue for her dress, just a like an undertone, well, a wash, like a wash. So I'm just going to use this cerulean blue, cerulean blue, got some water on this. Maybe, actually, I'm going to use that that glaze, a little water for now. Let's see what how it works. I'm just going to fill in the dress only, and there's some areas where there's pure bright sun, so it's going to be no color, so I'm just going to make a shadow mark, like, okay, right there. Yeah, the water's no good. I'm going to use that other, I don't like the water. I'm going to use this golden glaze stuff. So I'm going to take that off, first of all. I don't want the water on here. Okay. Let's try it. I'm gonna put it on the canvas and take some from the canvas and go right into cerulean blue. And I'm using that just a little bit for now. This. There's going to be some hair coming down. There'll be some light areas. Well, for now, I'm just going to try to draw it the way it goes, but I mean, paint it the way it's drawn, but it's very tricky. So. And actually, this is like
can't see the hairs in the way, so I think there's a little strap here and there, something like that, but this just goes there somewhere. But her hair comes down a little lower anyways. Like, I'd say like right down here somewhere. All right, I'll fix that after. I just want to get the colors in and her dress. Yeah, let me just do the undertone, and I'm gonna have to redraw that. Okay, let me get that color in first so it looks right. I'll use the liner brush later. Okay. That's a dress, no hat. It's gonna be a different, like a tan. I'm gonna do unbleached white on the hat. For the inner coating. And she's gonna have a sunflower on top of that. Right here. Comes up this way. All right. I'll put the sunflower there. Then a little strap. Same color, really, but I'm going to add shadows and stuff after. And blonde hair. I'm going to do the unbleached white. It's not blonde, it's really, it's like brunette, but. Highlights. The highlights will be the unbleached. So I'll just do a little shine there, a little here. And this curls over here. You're going to see. Alright, that's good. Let's get, all right, and then of course I'm bleached white skin tone. And these waves here, these are the foam. Define this. It's good, it's not right enough here and there. Thank you.
foamy things in here. Okay, just gonna put some lines. I'm gonna put it this way. I don't know what to say. Okay, I'm gonna do the dress now, I guess. For now, I'm gonna get some dark color and then we're gonna go over it later. So, pretty hair she has, oh that's so cute. Alright. Maybe light color up there, but alright, just put the base coat and we'll do the lines after. This is a straight up marine blue. I like this color, so I'm gonna use it. Okay, there's gonna be some flowers over there too. Dark over there. That's a straight view. Here. Just want to get her arms more defined, and well, I'm gonna make this hat a little bigger too. This hat comes down a little lower, just a little bit. Shadow areas here. brown. Bandit brown here. Some unbleached white, so get it up there on top. Sun's really hitting out of there and here. Thank you. All right, now. I need to get a liner brush. And some of that yellow ochre. A little bit of dark sienna and yellow ochre. This time more yellow ochre though. Find some of these curls, you know, and some of the highlights right here. And straight yellow ochre. Dots to show some texture here. Okay. We have to put shoulder. Yeah, I gotta put some dark color first. Skin tones are over here. Okay, I'm gonna stick a sunflower on the back of this. put a little orange in here, and dark sienna orange and yellow ochre all mixed, and then bright yellow also. Let's try and get the different tones. All right, now I'm just gonna get some white. And yellow. Dabs of white. Okay, something like that. Dark on the edges. Paint. Here. Not too much is going to mix in with the sunflower, so I'm going to take some of that out. Oh, too much water again. Ochre here. Yellow ochre here. that. Yeah. Skin tone, so I'm gonna get some slight, it's gonna be a pale, like orange and unbleached white on one side, a little tad of orange and unbleached white right here. This will bring it out now, so. Okay, this should be a lighter color, it's almost white. Back on this side. Clean unbleached white, just pure unbleached white. Thank you.
couple that have appeared too.
I gotta get some stems here. She's holding some. I'm just gonna put some flowers off the canvas. Oh, you can't see it, sorry. All over this. I'll bring it up just out to you and see it. Thank you.
daisies here.
Yeah, let's give some other flowers.
Thank you.
Excuse me. All right, that's good for the flowers.
Okay, orange, yellow, brown. Gotta get some shadow area. Shadow area, obviously. Now, hand is gonna go like this. A little wrist here. I mean, a little. Yeah, the other side, the underside of the wrist. And then some of this. The finger goes all the way to here. These hands. I gotta get some more paint.
Try to zoom in on this.
Alright, let's try. A light shining right here and the side of the elbow, and some shadows from this. I'm just going to get into fix the dress a little, just do a couple of highlights here on the edges.
see this ribbon a little better. I mean, this bow. Much better, much better. Now the dark side, a little in there too. Also, there we go. Orange, then yellow.
see this one.
Okay, I need a little white to find these. Just down as it goes. Getting some details of really here. Just a dab of white and yellow ochre. Thank you.
So I hope you guys like this. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day, everyone. Bye-bye.